praise tonight. We give you praise tonight. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise, excellent God. We give you praise, excellent God. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise, excellent God. We give you praise. Tonight we give you praise, Father. We give you praise. We give you praise, excellent God. We give you praise, excellent God. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise in the name of Jesus. 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 We give you praise tonight, Father. We give you praise. For you are God, and beside you there is no other God. There's no other God. There's no other Lord. There's no other Savior. There's no other Savior. There's no other Savior. There's no other God. Hallelujah. There's no other power. There's no other. Oh God, there's no other. There's no other. There's no other power. There's no other God. 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 There is no other God. There is no other God. There is no other power. There is no other power. There is no other authority. There is no other authority. There is no other authority. There is no other power or authority in the name of Jesus. Father, we trust you. We trust your leading. We trust you. We trust you, Lord. We trust you. We trust you. We trust you, Jesus. We trust you, Jesus. We trust you, Jesus. We trust you, Jesus. Oh, we trust you, Jesus. We trust you, Jesus. We trust you. In the name of Jesus, we trust you. We trust you. We trust you for life, for health, for strength. We trust you. We trust you. We trust you. We trust you, Father. We trust you. In the name of Jesus, we trust you. Oh, we trust you. We trust you, living God. We trust you, eternal Father. We trust you. Have mercy upon us. Let your will be done. Let your glory be revealed. Your mystery be made known. Have mercy upon us today. 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 In the name of Jesus. We trust you, excellent God. We trust you, marvelous Savior. We trust you. We trust your word. We trust you. We trust you. We trust you. Oh, we trust you, Jesus. We trust you. We trust you. We trust you. We trust you, excellent God. We trust you, marvelous Savior. Oh, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, 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 Jesus. We trust you, excellent God. We trust you, excellent God. We trust you. We trust your leading. 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 We trust you. We trust you tonight. In the name of Jesus, we trust you tonight. We trust you tonight. We trust you tonight. We trust you tonight. Excellent God, excellent God, excellent God. We trust you tonight. In the name of Jesus. There's none like you. There's none like you. There's none like you. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Father, tonight we pray that thou, God, will look upon these names that we will call before thee. We come before you in prayer tonight. Father, we come before thee in prayer tonight. We pray that thou, God, will look upon Lula Jones, Timothy McMungle, Evelyn Carter, Leela Ramirez, her family, her mother, father, look upon her mother, look upon her mother even right now. Touch, heal, and deliver this woman of God, Pastor Hernandez, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Look upon Pastor Hernandez. Look upon Shirley Kennedy, Kimberlyn Copeland, Jill Robertson, Jasmine Baker, Jennifer Gilchrist, in the name of Jesus. Rail Connors, in the name of Jesus. Jacqueline Hagen, oh glorious Father, look upon these your little ones. Jaquita Armstrong, Christina Medina, Shavanda Johnson, oh God, Winola Michael, Teresa Edwards, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, Jeremiah Cooper, Blessed Faith, Paul Williams, Cinder Tooney, Emulim. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Emmanuel. Emmanuel Benton. Thank you, Father. Henry Knox, Jacqueline Adusha Knob, Catherine Webster. In the name of Jesus, these are your little ones, God. Joseph Thomas. Father, every name that we call, every name that we call, breathe upon them. Every name that we call, breathe upon them. And everything that pertains to them, everything that pertains to them and their family, Father, their jobs, their loved ones, their friends, God, everything, hallelujah, that they have put prayers on themselves. Father, we include them in our prayers tonight. We include them in our prayers. Father, that you'll look upon them. Golden Girl Felicia, Pastor Charles Wisdom Rogers, oh God, Stephanie Bush, Benjamin Jackson, Gwinnett Houston, Darius Jones, oh Father, Brother Nugent, Philomena Mathau, Jennifer Harris, God, in the name of Jesus, Wilhelmina Perry Jackson, Dr. Irvin, oh God, Marcus Denby, Odell Williams, Leon Futch, Stephen Williams, Raymond Napa, Daniel Boyd, oh Father, Felina Hodge, Jeffrey Vincent Odom, Pamela Denise, Rodney Jones, Latanya Foreman, David Judge, in the name of Jesus, the Hagen family, yes God, the Hagen family, the Robinson family, the Anderson family, Zeddy Anderson, Sandra Baker, Deborah Cooper and family, God, Minnie Williams, Yvonne Roberts, Bernadette Davis, yes Father, in the name of Jesus, Bernadette Davis, Tasha Freeman, J. Devon Carter, Bishop Jackson, God, we pray that you would look upon him in the name of Jesus. Look upon Bishop Jackson. Touch, heal, deliver in the name of the Lord. Bishop Theodore Bacon, Sonia Terry, Sister Pat Douglas, Tammy Harris, Glenda Dozier, Lucinda Bacon, Donald Gamble, Rachel Garga, Shirley Jordan, Yvonne Roberts and her family, Sam Houston, Patrick Johnson, Al Green, Midnight Prayer Line, the Midnight Prayer Power Line, Henrietta Scott, in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Father, look now upon this your people in the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord. Look upon this your people, God. Look upon them. Oh, God. Dorcas Jones. Dorcas Jones. Rosemary Young. God's Chosen. Joshua Hagen. Yukal O'Connor. Stephen Hanks. Carlos Wooten. Nicole Bolden, Antoinette Norman, Annabella, yes, God, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, Ken Hales, Glenn Campbell, Fidi, yes, God, Fidi, Felicia, Michelle Gamunde, Father, in the name of Jesus, touch, heal, deliver, Daniela Carter, Golden, Joseph Yaney, Alfreda Golden, Gertia Harrington, yes God, Urgene Green, Kimberly Babers, yes God, Naima, hallelujah, James Williams Jr., Natasha Giles, Margaret Brown, Timmy Brown, Father, in the name of Jesus, and everything pertaining to them, oh God, and everything pertaining to the work there in Mississippi. Yes, Father, for Mississippi shall be saved in Jesus' mighty name. Anna Davis, Sarah Everson, Tamika Marie, Kingdom Nation, Evangelist Woods, Gary Cope, Joanne Aura, Herb Adu, Catherine Joy Griffin, Greatness Joy Aloysius, yes, Father, Latanya Brown. Oh God, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Stretch forth your hands to heal. Sean Johnson, Shirley Davis, Gail DK, Tony White, Gabrielle Williams. Oh Father, Marvin Smith, Emmanuel Sickie, Sama King,
Yes, Father. Deborah Houston, Deborah Houston, Penina, yes, God. Sharon Phillips, Joyce Quay, Just Dawn, in Jesus' mighty name. Luana Mitchell, Oliver Richard, Princess Noah, Tammy Kay. Yes, Father. Bobby Joanne Thomas. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Linda Noah. Sumo Noah. Prince Sai. Yes, God. Wanda Harden. Logu Queen. Maureen Miller. Sandra Baker. Tonya Ferguson. Yes, Father. Yes, Father. Yes, Father. Yes, Father. Michelle Lottie, Sally Russell, Lacosta Smooth, Donna Morton Ankrum, Edward Hayes, Joyce Thomas, Marie Richardson, Maurice Sweeney, yes, God, Misty, Dennis Williams, Renee Nelson, Sheila Norman, Taquisha Micah, Tiffany Hale, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. Taniqua Bedford, Wendy Brown Bacon, Wilma Brown, Christopher Momo, Crystal Johnson, Diamond Donahue, yes, God. Gail Bennett, yes, God, in the name of Jesus. Jeffrey Donahue, in Jesus' mighty name. Monique Houston Taylor. Oh, God, Teresa Gripper, yes, Father, Timmy Brown, Anthony Johnson, Carmela Sabaz, Dinesh Kumar, Donald Gamble Jr., yes, Cynthia Bryan, James Jordan, in the name of Jesus, Alicia Phillips, Azu Sutton, Michael Doss, Clemens Walker, Daisy Scott, Ted Scott, Lamont Scott, yes, Father, Eric Johnson, Ronald Parker, Angela Roberts, Brenda Rich Golden, yes, Father, the Golden Family, Bridget Russell, oh, Deborah Middleton, Ernest Williams, yes, Father, yes, Father, Edward White, yes, Father, in the name of Jesus, Christy Ray, LaTanya Hightower, Shikandra, Houston, Tina Turner, Tina Hagen Turner, yes, Father, in the name of Jesus, Wendy Ann Lynch, oh, Father, stretch forth your hands to heal, Alicia Walker, Amber Johns, Amber Shea, oh, Father, stretch forth your hands, Darlene White, yes, Janice Hannigan, yes, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lovejoy, yes, Father, in the name of the Lord. Marquita Spann, Michael McCray, yes, Father. Sabina Butner, Sandra Hagen, Shirley Hollis, Tanya Freeman, Williams Lipsy, oh my God, hallelujah. Erska, Yashika Williams, Father, look upon these your little ones. Look upon them. Aaron Hill, look upon them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And we cry out to thee concerning their life. Father, we pray now that thou would intervene, that thou would heal, that thou would touch, heal, and deliver, that thou would raise up, God, in the name of Jesus. Let your glory be revealed. Let your mystery be made known. For you are the God that heals. You are the God that delivers. You are the God, hallelujah, that come through for us. Even tonight, oh God, come through for us. Come through for your children. Come through for us. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, we give you the praise and the glory and the honor is yours. Salvation and strength is yours. Power and might is yours. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord. We give you praise, Father. We give you praise. 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 We give you praise, excellent God. We give you praise, marvelous Savior. We give you praise for the things that thou art doing. For the things that you're doing, they are excellent. They are marvelous in our eyes. In the name of the Lord. We thank you this day. We thank you, excellent God. We thank you, marvelous Savior. We thank you. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight for loving us. We thank you tonight, oh Father, for showing us your mercy. Forgive us of all sins. As we approach your throne tonight, Father, forgive us of all sins. 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 In the name of Jesus, cause us to lose ourselves in you. Lose ourselves in you and come before you in transparency. In the name of Jesus, holding nothing back. Holding nothing back. Not connected to anything but your love. To nothing but your word. Nothing but salvation. Father, that you're the only one that can help us, heal us, and turn us towards you. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we lay aside every weight and the sin which do so easily beset us. And we run this race with patience, looking to you, the author and the finisher of our faith. We cry out to thee tonight. We cry out to you. We cry out to you. We cry out to you, O Lamb of God, that takes away all of the sins of the world. We cry out to you. Look upon us tonight. Look upon us. Look upon us. Look upon Pastor Hernandez. Look upon Pastor Hernandez, God. Look upon this woman of God. Touch, heal, and deliver. Touch her. Touch her body. Touch her body even right now. Touch her body right now. Touch, heal, and deliver. In Jesus' mighty name, for your glory. For your glory, for your glory, for your glory, we cry out, God, and we spare not. We lift up our voices before thee, O God, that you know what your people walking in. You know us. You know us, O God. And tonight, as we surrender ourselves to thee, we throw ourselves at the mercy of the cross, at the mercy of the blood of Jesus. We throw ourselves, oh God, and we plunge ourselves beneath your word, that your word will save us and heal us and undergird us and strengthen us in the name of Jesus. That we adorn our head, oh God, with the helmet of salvation, with the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Father, as we adorn ourselves and you look upon us this night, forgive us of all sins. Forgive us of all sins, knowing and unknowing. Forgive us of all sin, sin dormant, sin laying dormant for years, sins and sins and habits, sins and habits, sins and habits, things that have been prolonged in our lives through traditions, through culture, God, the sins of culture, the sins of traditions, the sins of habits. Oh, Father, look upon us, oh God, the sins of ignorance, the sins of blindness, the sins of lameness, the sins of assumption. The sins of exaggeration. Father, look upon us tonight. The sins that come to bind, the sins that come to hinder in the name of Jesus. Look upon us this night, O God, and have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, O God. Lift us from where we're down. Bring us in from where we're out. Forgive us for where we're wrong. Father, forgive us. Forgive us this night. Forgive us this night. Forgive us this night and show us your glory. Show us your glory. Show us your glory, excellent God. Show us your glory. Show us your glory tonight. Tonight, Heavenly Father, show us your will concerning us. Show us your will. Show us your will for our lives. Show us your will. Show us your will. Show us your will for our lives in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, tonight is our healing season. This is our healing season tonight. This is our healing season, and we come before thee, O God, that before we even cast our cares upon thee, before we even lay our requests down at your feet, Father, we come that we might sanctify our mind. Ah, first and foremost, that I will sanctify our mind. We will wash our mind. We will wash our mind in the helmet of salvation. We will wash our thought in salvation. We will cleanse our thought in salvation. We will cleanse our mind in salvation. We will cleanse our thought. Oh, Father, we'll lay aside every weight and the sin which do so easily beset us. And we ask of thee, Father, to forgive us. Forgive us of the sins of assumption, assuming things that have not been verified, assuming things that have been wrong, speaking guile, speaking evil, speaking, oh God, negative, speaking bondage, speaking ill, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, speaking things that are not true concerning you. We have been speaking those things concerning you, concerning ourselves, been walking in bondage, been walking in a place, God, of just void of success, void of happiness, void of joy, void of that, a place of depression and oppression. Father, forgive us. Forgive us, forgive us, forgive us that we've come to a place that we've walked in pity. That we have want others to pity us. We want others to pity us. Oh, Father, we want people to pity us. We want to pity ourselves and look down upon ourselves. And we have lost our way. We've lost our way to you. We've lost our prayer life. We have lost, you. We've lost you in the shuffle, Father, for we've been shuffling our lives. We've been shuffling our lives with people, shuffling our lives with things, shuffling our lives in education, shuffling our lives here and there, and been careless with our lives, careless with our walk, careless with our talk, careless with our prayer life, careless with our lives, oh God. And as we've been careless, we begin to walk in the habits of our lives, habits of tradition, habits of culture, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. For so long, we have not included you in our life. We have not included you in the day-to-day grind, the day-to-day move, the day-to-day blessedness of living. We have not included you. But tonight, Father, give us understanding. Give us a shift and a change of heart, a change of spirit. Father, change our heart, change our mind. And tonight, as we come before thee, oh God, hallelujah, change our story. Yes, we want to be healed. Yes, we want to be delivered. Yes, we want to turn around. And yes, this is our healing season. But Father, we pray now that thou would help us gird up our mind. Gird up our mind and we sanctify our thoughts. Gird up our mind and we sanctify our life. We gird up our mind. We gird up our mind. We gird up our mind in righteousness. We gird up our mind in salvation. We gird up our mind in purity. In Jesus' name, have mercy upon us, O God. Forgive us of all sins. Blot out our transgressions. Create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us. In the name of Jesus, for we are realizing that it's not always the big sins that destroy us. It's not always the big thing that kills us. But a lot of times it's the small things, Father. It's the way we look at ourselves and the way we think that you look at us. We think that you want to kill us because we have not crossed every T and dot every I. We think that you just want to discard us because we have not gotten our lives right even up to this point, Father. And we have a wrong view of you. But Father, as of tonight, help us tonight. Help us tonight. Help us tonight. Help us tonight. Help us to really press into you. To really cry out to thee, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Excellent God, your will must be done. Your glory must be revealed. Your mysteries must be made known. And we need you this night, Father. We need you tonight. We need you tonight. We need you tonight. And we are crying out to thee that you are the living God. You are the God of our life. You are the God of salvation. In the name of Jesus. And we thank you even right now. Hallelujah. As we approach you, Father, we approach you in spirit and in truth. And tonight we realize that, hallelujah, that we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. We believe in the Lord Jesus, for this is our healing season. Hallelujah. Believe in the Lord Jesus for your healing season, for this is our healing season. This right here is our healing season. This is our healing season. We believe you. We believe in the Lord Jesus. hallelujah, for our healing season. This is my healing season. This is my healing season. I am in 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 my season of healing, season of outpouring. I'm in my healing season. I am in my deliverance season. I am in my deliverance season. I am in my deliverance season. I am in the season where I will be delivered. I am in the season where I will be healed. I am in the season where I will receive turnaround. I am in the season where yokes will be destroyed. I am in the season of my greatest push forward. I am in the season, oh God, I am in the season of beginning my ministry. I am in the season of walking in the ministry. I am in the season, oh God, of employment, of being employed by the Lord Jesus Christ. I am in my season. I am in my season of greatness. I am in my season of greatness, and it shall not be diminished. I am in my season of greatness, and it shall not be diminished. I wish somebody would say that. I am in my healing season. I am in my season of greatness, and it shall not be diminished. I am in my season of greatness. This is my season of greatness, and it shall not be diminished in the name of Jesus. I will not be offset, will not be bamboozled, will not be hoodwinked. In the name of Jesus, for this is the season of greatness. This is my season. This is my season. This is my season. This is my season where I will be advanced in the things of God. I will be advanced. I will be advanced in the wisdom of God. I will be advanced. I will be advanced. My prayer will be advanced. My prayer language will advance. Hallelujah. My healing will advance. My praise will be advanced. I will be promoted in the realm of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus, to do great exploits, I will pikashi ne te kabatala halakasiya te andalala batale ekete nabashiandele kete malakasiando kopoteke de nashiandele kete palakasiando kolokose namanani itiababa talakoso abakalaka nianenete palikate yando tolokote palakasi I iniyamana kasiando tobote abata in the namanasi anilikote in the mighty name of Jesus kaliose niyamana in the name of Jesus in the mighty 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 name of Jesus. For this is my healing season. This is my season of deliverance. This is my season of breakthrough. This is my season of turnaround. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, we will receive healing. We will receive deliverance. We will come forth in you in the name of Jesus. And we will pray and we will destroy the spirit of cancer. We will pray and we will destroy the spirit of cancer and tumors and high blood and sickle cells. Oh God, and everything that's working against us, and stroke, oh God, and tumors, and high blood, and low blood, and sickle cells, and sugar diabetes. Father, we come against these things in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. And while the people are praying, oh God, while the people are praying, tonight we pray and destroy the spirit of cancer. In the name of Jesus, oh Father, that as we pray to destroy the spirit of cancer, Father, give your people understanding. Give your people understanding concerning this spirit. Give your people understanding concerning this spirit, against this, concerning this infirmity. Give your people understanding against this infirmity, against this disease, against this spirit. Father, reveal. Reveal the networkings of it. Reveal, oh God. Reveal the diabolical scheme of it. Reveal the diabolical plan of it. In the name of Jesus. Father, reveal the diabolical plan of cancer, of this sickness, disease, God. Reveal. Pull the cover off of it. Pull the cover. Pull the cover. Pull the cover. Pull the cover. Pull the cover, God. Pull the cover. Pull the cover and cause this people to walk in spiritual discernment, discerning of spirits, oh God, discerning of spirits, including sickness, disease, stroke, cancer, tumors, high blood, low blood, sickle cells, oh God, anything that is an affirmed spirit, anything that is a cancerous spirit, anything that is a spirit of sickness, anything that is a spirit that comes to offset the lives of your children, Father, give your children understanding. Give your children understanding. Give your children understanding to know how to defeat this spirit, to know how to defeat this spirit that come to bind, to know how to come to, oh God, let them know how to defeat this spirit that come to offset them. Let them know how to, oh God, defeat this spirit that comes, oh God, to hinder their life, to hinder their walk in the name of Jesus. Father, give wisdom, give understanding, give wisdom, give understanding. Give your children the advantage. Give them the edge. Give them the upper hand. Oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray now that thou would give your children insight. Insight. There are too many falling by the wayside. Too many are stumbling and falling in the name of Jesus. And while this spirit is an encroaching upon the people of God, even in the houses, even in the churches, even in the places of worship, even in the prayer meetings, the same spirit is encroaching upon our belief, our norm. Oh God, as we seek your face and we call upon you, there's a spirit, God, that's on the devourer, that's seeking whom it may devour, seeking whom it may destroy. But tonight, oh God, we pray for insight. We pray for wisdom. We pray for knowledge. We pray, God, that thou would give unto your little ones the gift of discerning of spirits. Father, give them the gift of discerning of spirits. Breathe upon them the gift of discerning of spirits, to let them know what they're up against, to let them know what is at the turn of the century, to let them know what is the turn around the corner, to let them know the spirit that is working in this region, Father, expose every hidden agenda of the spirit that worked in this region in the name of Jesus. And as your children go forth, God, in whatever region they're in, whatever city, whatever state, whatever town, whatever village, whatever continent, Father, let them know whatever spirit that is working there, whatever agenda that spirit is working with, God, in the name of Jesus. And give your little ones the advantage. Give them the edge. Give them the upper hand. Give them the wisdom. Give them the wisdom to counter every attack in the name of Jesus, that they will not be bamboozled. They will not be hoodwinked. Oh, God, they will not be off. Set. They will not be disadvantaged in the name of Jesus. Your little one will not be disadvantaged. Your little one will not be disadvantaged. They will not walk in ignorance. They will not be blindsided. In Shikarasha Tidi, Kedeabata, Habashianilikitia, Shenada, Kala, 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 Kaleando, Shebataya, Okote Katataya, Ayataya, in the name of Nick, Ishapataya. In the name of Jesus, they will not be offset. 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 They will not be disadvantaged. They will not be disadvantaged, but you will give your children the upper hand. Your word declares it, Father. Your word declares it. Your word declares it. I will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on me. I will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on me. I will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on me. Though sickness is operating at their life, though sickness is knocking on their door. Hallelujah. Oh God, though fear is knocking on their door, though lies is trying to entrap them. Oh God, though the lust of the flesh is trying to defeat them. Oh God, you will keep them in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on me. Every snare of the enemy, every snare of the devil, every snare of entrapment, every snare of temptation, every snare of disease, every snare of sickness, every snare that come to detain, that come to hold back, to come to stop, to come to render blind and helpless. Father, we come against it even right now. Expose the deviant plan of the enemy. Expose, God. Expose, and render the enemy blind and helpless in the name of Jesus. Father, give your children the advantage. 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 And let them know, God, how to withstand. When they have done all that they know how to withstand, show them how to withstand and stand, even in the evil day, that they will not succumb to the pressures of life. They will not succumb to the evil. They will not succumb to the wickedness. They will not succumb to the violence in the name of Jesus. For you will keep them in perfect peace. As your word declare, you will keep them in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on me. You will lift them up. You will keep them from falling. You will present them faultless before the presence of your glory with exceeding joy to the only wise God, our Savior, with glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Father, you will do a great work in their life. You will do a great work in their life. Father, advance your children. Advance your children to another level. Advance your children to another level in prayer. Advance your children to another level. Advance your children. Advance your children. Give them every reason to want to be in your throne room. Give them every reason to want to be in your council. Give them every reason, God, every reason. Every reason. Give your children. Let them come to that place. Let them come to the realization. Let them come to the place of knowing that every reason, it doesn't matter the reason. Give them, oh God, to come to the place that they would bring themselves to that place, to that awareness, God, that it doesn't matter the outcome. It doesn't matter the look, God, that no matter what it takes, I need to be in the counsel of the Most High. I need to dwell in the presence of the Most High. Father, let this linger in their spirit. Let this linger on them. Let them rest on the spirit. Let them rest on the spirit, God. Let this be their prevailing desire. Let this be their prevailing desire, their prevailing hunger, oh God, that I've got to be in your counsel. I've got to lay before thee, oh God. I've got to be inclined within thy presence. I've got to be in your presence, oh God. I've got to know the things of God. I need to hear your voice. I need to hear what you desire of us. What is it that the Lord desire of us? What is it that you desire? As the writer have written in the book of the Psalms, God, what is it that the Lord desire of us? What do you desire of us? What is it that you're asking of us in the name of Jesus? To believe in the Lord, to believe in the Lord, to believe in the Lord in this season, to believe you, to trust you, to trust you, to believe you, to lean not to our own understanding, but in all of our ways acknowledge you, that you will direct our path in the name of Jesus. Father, Habateina, Namania, Shatapaya, Kashapale, Kashapaya, 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 Kashapale, Kashiandelekete, Kalapasia, Kaleapasia, Kaleapasia, Kepa, Kappa, Kappa, Kashiandelekete, Apaleasiano, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, let your little ones trust you with all of their heart, soul, mind, body, and strength. Let them trust you for their healing. Let them trust you for their deliverance. Let them trust you for their breakthrough. Let them trust you. They will not make excuses. They will not make excuses. They will not make excuses as the man did in John 5. In John 5, 1 through 17, as the man began to make excuses, Father, your children will not make excuses, for they will rest their case in you. They will rest their desire in you. They will rest their petitions in you. Oh, Father, call them to fix their eyes on you. Call them to fix their prayers on you. Call them to fix their intent, their desires, God. Call them to fix the hunger on you, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that they will walk in you and not be ashamed. They will carry your name and not be ashamed. They will carry the honor of God and not be ashamed. They will carry the grace of God and not be ashamed. They will carry the gospel of Jesus Christ and not be ashamed. Hallelujah. They will talk about the kingdom of God. They will preach about the kingdom of God and his righteousness and not be ashamed. Oh God, they will not be ashamed of the gospel of salvation, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that will believe, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. Father, they will not be ashamed of your word. They will not be ashamed to carry your word. We will not be ashamed to walk in your spirit. We will not be ashamed to honor you. We will not be ashamed to bow to you. We will not be ashamed to acknowledge you. We will not be ashamed to carry you. We will not be ashamed. We will not be ashamed. We will not be ashamed to cry aloud and spare not and lift up our voice like a trumpet to show your people their transgressions and the house of Jacob their sin. Father, we will weather every storm. We will stand against every opposition in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we stand for truth. We stand for righteousness. We stand for righteousness. We stand for righteousness. Father, banner over our head is your love. Your love is the banner over our head. Your banner is the your banner over me. Your banner over me proclaims love. Your banner over my head is love. The banner over my head says love. It's the love of God. It is the love of God. It is the love of God that make me who I am. It is the love of God, the reason why I am where I am. It is the love of God. It is the love of God that sustains me. It is the love of God that keeps me. It is the love of God that lifts me. It is the love of God that brings me. It is the love of God that, hallelujah, that give me strength. Give me mobility. Oh, glory to God, that allow me to speak in your name. Oh, to testify in your name, to walk in your name, to be strengthened by you in the name of Jesus. For I can do nothing in my own self. Oh, glory to God. For we can do nothing of our own self. The Son can do nothing of his own self. The Son can do nothing of his own self. But everything that you send to me will come to me in the name of Jesus. For the Son can do nothing of his own self. The Son can do nothing of his own self. The Son have no power without God. The Son have no power without the Father. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And all that you send to me, Father, none shall be lost. All that you send to me, Father, none shall be lost. In the name of Jesus. And you have not given me the spirit to have to take the advantage of that you have sent to me. In the name of Jesus. None will be taken advantage of. But all that you sent to me will be loved by the love of the Father. Will be kept by the keeping of our Father. Will be blessed by the blessings of our Father. Will be helped by the helping of our Father. Will be advanced by the advancing of our Father. In the name of Jesus. But thou hast made me a teacher. Thou hast made me a teacher. Thou hast made me to be a peacemaker. In the name of Jesus. Father, I shall walk in that vein. I shall walk in the vein of a peacemaker. I shall walk in the vein of a lifter. I shall walk in the vein. I shall walk in that vein. Oh God, to restore man into the rightful place. The place of loving you. The place of following you. The place of doing your will, oh God. In the name of Jesus. And all of my members. All of my members. All of my members. All the members of my body. All the members of my body. In the name of Jesus. My hands, my eyes, my feet, my leg, my toes, my ears. Hallelujah. My mouth, God. Hallelujah. Everything about me. Every part of me. Every external part of me. Every internal part of me will work in harmony. In the name of Jesus. To see that souls are saved. To see that blinded eyes are open. To see that death is the unstopped. To see that the lame are ever to walk. In the mighty name of Jesus. For the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. For you has anointed me to preach the gospel in this season. For this is my winning season. 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 In the name of Jesus. This is my winning season. This is my winning season. This is my winning season. In the name of Jesus. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For thou hast lifted me. Thou hast lifted me. Thou hast lifted me. Thou hast turned my life around. Thou hast brought me out of the darkness. Thou hast brought me up out of a horrible pit. You've established my goings. And Father, I give you praise. I give you praise, for I'm nothing without you. I am nothing without you. I am nothing without you. I am helpless without you. I'm nothing without you, oh God. And it's you that I look to. It is you that I look to in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we stretch forth our hands to thee. No other help we know. If thou withdraw thyself from us, oh, where shall we go? In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the living God. Father, we believe you. We believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. We believe in the Lord Jesus Christ for our healing. For this is my healing season. Now is my healing season. This is my healing season. In the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. Hallelujah. What makes this my healing season? What makes this my healing season? What makes this my healing season? I want to read before you the scriptures. I want to read into your hearing. I want to read to your hearing the scriptures that we have posted. We've been reading it all this week. John 5:1-17. Hallelujah. Believe in the Lord Jesus, for your healing season is now. Believe in the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. For your healing season is now. Believe in the Lord Jesus, for your healing season is now. My healing season is now. My healing season is now. I'm in the middle of my healing season. I'm in the midst of my healing season. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, allow me, as we begin to pray again, Father, as we pray concerning the scripture, Father, I pray that thou would advance us with understanding, with revelation knowledge. Give us divine insight. What is this scripture conveying to us tonight? What is this scripture conveying to us concerning healing? My healing season is now. If I believe you, I believe you. My healing season is now. Father, let this scripture convey your truth to us. Let this scripture open up my understanding, that I might know that my season is now. How do I know that this is my season? Will your scripture speak to us and let us know that this is my healing season? What is different now that is different? What is so different about then and now? During this gentleman's time when he sat by the pool of Bethesda and today, what makes this different? What makes this different? What makes this different in my life? What makes this different? Father, help me to understand this. Help the people to understand this. Give us wisdom from this. Give us wisdom. Give us understanding. Advance us, O God. Advance us. Speak to us. Speak to us that we will hear you. Speak to us concerning this word. In the name of Jesus. And we give you praise, and the glory and honor is yours. Hallelujah. Believe in the Lord Jesus, for your healing season is now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's look at the scripture. Coming from John 5, 1 through 17. Believe in the Lord Jesus, for your healing season is now. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the waters. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, blind, limping, withered, waiting for the moving of the waters. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool, troubled the waters. Whosoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in, was made whole of whosoever, of whatsoever disease he had. Father, I thank you for in this scripture, we are learning that it was a certain season. A certain season. The scripture didn't say that everybody was healed at this season, but whoever stepped in first, whoever stepped in first, whosoever stepped in first, that when the season came, whoever stepped in first, Father, that man, this man waited a long time. He was infirm with this spirit. He was infirm with this problem for 38 years. 38 years he had this problem. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity for 38 years. I know it did not say that he sat at this pool for 38 years, but he had infirmity for 38 years. And when Jesus saw him lie there, Jesus knew that he had been now a long time in that case. In that case, not in that place, but in that case. He says unto him, "Wilt thou be made whole?" The season, you can miss out in your season. Because in that season, so many could jump down before you. So many can step before you. So many can get what was happening then before you. As I look at the story in Abraham when he was blessing his sons. When he was blessing his sons, Jacob received the blessing and left. Esau came in later and told his father, "Bless me." And father said, "I have already blessed your brother." He says, "Have you not another blessing for me, O father? Have you not another blessing? Have you not another blessing?" My God, it makes so much sense. Have you not another blessing? You could only pass out one blessing at a time. That's all you have. You have no other blessings. There is no more blessings in you. Bless me, O father. Bless me. Bless me, father. Bless me. I am so glad, Layla. I am so glad that it's not that way with Jesus. I am so glad that what the people was governed under then, we are not governed under today. I'm so glad, hallelujah, that you don't have to sit at the pool of Bethesda and with thousands of people waiting for the moving of the water. And it just take, if all these people would with it, all these people were blind and halt, and all these people had problems, and when the water was troubled, and somebody jumped in before everybody else, that person got healed. And everybody else just waited in vain. It didn't say, I'm not saying that's have to be the way it is. But according to this story, that man says, for an angel went down, the scripture says, for an angel went down at a season, a certain season, into the pool, troubled the water. Whosoever then first, after the troubling of the water, stepped in, was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. This man, a certain man was there, which had an infirmity 38 years. But for all the years that he was there, I don't know how long he was there, he always came up empty-handed. But it's not just him that came up empty-handed. So many others came up empty-handed. There was other people with withered hands, withered legs. They were withered. They came up empty-handed. So many other people that was limping came up empty-handed. So many other people that were blind came up empty-handed. So many other impotent folk, not just this one, came up empty-handed. Somebody stepped in before them. Somebody stepped in before them. Somebody stepped in before them. Somebody stepped in before all the others. And they had to leave that place and look for another season, that they would come and return again. It's there in the scriptures. But I'm so glad what makes it different from that season to this season. In this season, everybody can be delivered. In this season, everybody can be delivered. This season is different from that season. That season, an angel came down and troubled the water, and whoever stepped in first was the condition. They received it. This man was there. He was there faithfully. He was there often. He was there for many years. And he kept coming. But he didn't get his. He did not receive what was available. He didn't get his. He didn't get it. And many of us are still not getting it. We go to church and we're still not getting it. We're at the place. We're at the pool, but we're not getting it. The water get troubled for others, but we are not getting it. So many others speak in tongue and jump and run and dance and praise the Lord. And you can see the power of God working on them. But there are a lot of others that go there and they get missed out. They don't get it. Everybody doesn't get it. It should get it. They should get it. But everybody doesn't really meet the condition for a miracle. Everybody not walking in that capacity to receive a miracle, to receive deliverance, to receive a breakthrough. But what's so different about then and now? Where the angel came down and troubled the water then. In this case, the Lord is troubling the water now. He says, whosoever will, let him come. Whosoever will, let him come. Whosoever will, let him come. I got room for you. Whosoever will, let him come. Whosoever, 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 whosoever. The pool is open to whosoever. It's not limited. It's not limited. It's not limited to one. It's not limited to just a few. It is open to whosoever will come. Let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, I'll make them white as wool. Though they be red, hallelujah, like crimson, I'll make them white as blood, white as snow. Come now, let us reason together. Come now, come now. Whoever you are, let's reason together. Come now, let us reason together. Come now, let us reason together. Doesn't matter what it's looked like. Doesn't matter how it seemed. Doesn't matter what you've had to deal with. Doesn't matter. Come now, let us reason together. Come, 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 let us reason. This is your healing season. And the good thing about your healing season is it doesn't have to be one time only. It doesn't have to be a one-time thing only. And your healing season doesn't just end right after you get healed. But take that same healing season and make it your praising season. Make it your blessing seasons. Make it your deliverance season. Make it your breakthrough season. Make it your fellowship season. Make it your season of worship. Make it your season of gratitude, your season of thankfulness. Thanksgiving season. Hallelujah. Your season doesn't have to run out. You don't have to run out. If somebody else get healed and you got to wait, go home and wait and do this again for another season. No, you don't have to do that. In this season, whosoever will, let him come. Come, come now. Let us reason together. Come now. The Lord is knocking at the door. He's troubling the water. He's troubling your water even right now. The day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. That's what makes it so different now. The day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. The day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. The day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. The day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. But notice the correlation. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind folk, crippled folk, withered folk, waiting for the moving of the waters. And Jesus says to this man, "Wilt thou be made whole?" He made excuses, but Jesus wants to know, "Wilt thou be made whole?" That's all I want to know. Wilt you be made whole? That's it. Will you be made whole? Jesus tells the man to take up that bed and walk. But notice something else. Jesus meet the man. Jesus meet the man in another place. Notice the correlation. In verse 14, Jesus meet the man in verse number 14. This is where Jesus meets him. Notice what Jesus says to the man in verse 14 and how Jesus responds to him. After Jesus finds him in the temple and says unto him, because the man went to temple, he was a Templite. He went to the temple. He would go and worship. But notice what Jesus says unto him. After Jesus findeth him in the temple and says unto him, "Behold, thou art made whole." And Jesus said to the man, "Sin no more, lest the worst thing come upon thee." Sin no more, lest the worst thing come unto thee. What? 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 Sin no more, lest the worst thing come unto thee. Sin no more, lest the worst thing come upon. Who are you talking to, Jesus? Everybody here are impotent folk. Impotent folk. Everybody here are impotent folk. They're either blind, they're impotent, they're blind, they're halt, they're limping, they're withered. In other words, everybody here are handicapped. Everybody here are handicapped. What's keeping them handicapped? What's keeping them in this handicapped posture? Hear me, somebody. What is it that's keeping them in this handicapped posture? Jesus delivered the man from the handicapped posture, and Jesus finds him in the temple. And Jesus says to him, "Thou art made whole. Sin no more." Huh? "Sin no more, lest the worst thing come upon thee." What do you mean a worst thing? Worse than handicap? Yes, worse than handicap. So handicap, no matter what you call it, people who are handicapped. You say, "But they were born like this." Some of them were born like this. It's still as a result of the spirit of sin. is still a result of a sin altar. The altar of sin. Jesus. Destroy that altar. If you destroy that altar of sin, you'll destroy that thing that binding them. What is it that's keeping them so long? Sin. What is it that's holding them hostage? Sin. What is keeping them bound? Sin. What is keeping them handicapped? Sin. What is keeping them in that way? Sin. But maybe I'm not guilty of physically sinning. Maybe I'm not guilty of sinning in that way. I'm not physically sinning. I bore like this from my mother's womb. I was shaped in iniquity like this. You were shaped in iniquity from your mother's womb. You're right. But I'm not guilty of doing this. I'm not guilty of actually carrying this out. So how did I get this way? The Bible says that which is not of faith is sin. If you are a non-believer, you're already in sin. If you're not believing him for your healing, you're already in sin. If you're not believing him to fix you, to turn you away from this, to lift you, you're already in sin. If you don't believe that he's able, if you don't believe that he can do it, if you don't believe that he's ready to give you a fresh start, you're already in sin. That which is not of faith is sin. Oftentimes we plunge ourselves in sin. And we are handicapped in sin. And we'll stay there for a long time in sin because we failed to simply believe him. We failed to trust him. The Lord is coming back. He says that when he returns, shall he find F-A-I-T-H on the earth. Tonight, Father, forgive us. Forgive us for walking in sin. And there are times we're in sin and don't even realize we're in sin. We're trying to keep ourselves from sin. We're trying to not wallow in sin, not walk in sin, not partake of sin, not consume sin, not indulge in sin, not to be tempted by sin, not to be swayed by sin, not to even allow sin to have the upper hand. Father, we fight against this thing. We're not trying to carry out the mandates of sin. But we didn't realize Until tonight, your word reveals to us, hallelujah, that which is not of faith is sin. And we could be walking in sin and not even realize it. We've not even asked you to forgive us. But your word says it right there in the word of God. Jesus tells the man, findeth him. It's so necessary. Jesus is so necessary. Jesus is doing this. So intentionally, it is the intention of Jesus to find a man. But because I got to leave him with the word. And afterward, Jesus finds him in the temple. Deliberately finds him, intentionally finds him in the temple. Says unto him, behold, thou art made whole. And now that you're made whole, sin no more. What you mean sin no more? Not don't go out and sin. Yes, I'm intentionally sinning then when I go out to sin. But he said, sin no more. As if I've done it already. Sin no more. That's the worst thing than being handicapped. Come unto thee. Father, forgive us tonight. Forgive us tonight. Forgive us tonight. Forgive us tonight. That we will trust you, we believe you. And Father, help us where we are weak, where our faith is weak. We didn't realize we were sinning against you. Where our faith had become weak, God, forgive us. Help us to trust you. Help us to stand on your word. Father, we have sinned against thee, and thee only have we sinned and done this evil, this wickedness in thy sight. Father, wash our slate cleanse. Clean us, O God. Forgive us, O God. Blot out our transgressions. Create in us a clean heart. Renew a right spirit within us. Give us the upper hand. Father, we've asked you to expose the corporate. Expose the thing that have us bound. Expose it. We've even asked you, O God, in our prayer tonight, we've even asked you to pray and destroy the spirit of cancer. But how can we destroy the spirit of cancer if we not realize you're just helping us, Father, and we thank you. That we cannot destroy the spirit of cancer when we are already in doubt. We're already sinners. We're not believing you. We're going through a ritual. We're going through a formality. Our hands are yet dirty. Our hands are yet not clean because there's sin in our life. But tonight, we reverse that curse. We reverse that methodology. We reverse that syndrome. We reverse it tonight, God. We reverse it tonight by asking you to cleanse our heart, cleanse our mind, cleanse us, oh God, that our faith must be activated. And help us to work on our belief. Help us to work on our faith, oh God. Help us to trust you. Help us to trust you. Your word says that faith come by hearing, hearing by the word of God. Father, help us to go back to the drawing board and really begin to bathe ourselves in faith. Bathe ourselves in your word. We must bathe ourselves in your word so that we will not doubt you. We'll bathe ourselves in faith, God, in your word, in your word. We will bathe ourselves in your word that your word will come alive in us. That we will believe you. We will trust you. We will trust you for healing. We will trust you for deliverance. We will trust you for breakthrough. We will trust you that whatever you said, God, we believe you. We cast our cares upon you because you care for us. We will not doubt you. We will not doubt you. We will not doubt you. We will believe you. Help us to believe you. Tonight we believe you. Tonight we stand on your word. We believe you. Tonight we walk in faith, God. But Father, as the disciples said then, we say now. Father, help our unbelief. Help us to walk in true faith. Help us to really believe you. Help us to really come back to the drawing board of really making Jesus our all, making Jesus our own. Really submitting to you, really reverencing you, really believing you, really trusting you. Trusting you for healing. Trusting you for deliverance. Trusting you for a turnaround. For this spirit of cancer is going to be destroyed. And not only the spirit of cancer, but tumors and high blood and low blood and diabetes and sugar and sickle cells and infirmity and everything that we've been dealing with as a people. If we're going to be delivered from that thing, Father, help us to trust you. Help us to believe you. Help us to come back to trusting you. We began trusting men, trusting others, trusting doctors, trusting lawyers, trusting family and friends, trusting people who have money, purchasing money, borrowing things, trying to take measures into our own hands, but have not been trusting you. Tonight, forgive us. Forgive us. And we trust you tonight in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Father, let your glory be revealed. Let your mystery be made known. Let the peace of God rule in our heart. We receive your peace, Father. We receive your peace. Thank you for hearing us. Thank you for giving us the advantage. Thank you for giving us the upper hand. Thank you for advancing our way. Thank you for, oh God, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for revealing to us the corporate. Thank you for revealing it to us. The hidden agenda of sin. Sin has been in our life and we have not realized it. Sin has been in our life, God. Sin has been in our life. Sin has been the thing that's been in our life and we haven't even realized it. We were living in sin, walking in sin, doing things in sin, and didn't realize that we were sinning when we just don't trust you. For that which is not of faith is sin. Father, forgive us. We say we're believers. We're testifying that we're believers. But in actuality, we are doubters. Father, forgive us. Help our unbelief. Turn our lives around. In Jesus' mighty name. To God be the glory. God bless you. God keep you. Heaven smile upon you. Listen, I thank God for this moment. I thank God for this insight. Thank God for this revelation. And as you begin to pray, people of God, as you begin to pray, You know what to pray. Ask God to help you. This is our healing season. And in the healing season, in order for us to be healed, something got to be exposed. In this case, the pus of it is their sin. The sin of it is we have not really been trusting God like we say we are trusting him. We have been falling short. That's the pus of the matter. But to extract the pus of the matter and put the spiritual, hallelujah, to put the spiritual, almost said iodine, but to put the spiritual salve on it that's going to extract the pus, to put the spiritual salve on it that's going to drain out, pull out, extract out all of the pus, all of the sin out of the matter is forgiveness, asking God to forgive us. And then from there, asking God, show us what to do and how to do it, how to walk in faith, how to walk by faith and not by sight, how to really build up our faith bank and not doubt you anymore. That we will not doubt you anymore. We will not doubt your word. We will only believe in Jesus' name. So the Lord come to expose the enemy. And as he come to expose the enemy, let us go back and start with some building blocks, the principles of walking in him, believing him, standing on him, and knowing that God loves us too much to fail. He loves us too much to fail, all right? He loves us too much to allow us to fail. But these things come to not just reprimand us so that we would get it right. Reprimand come that we would get it right. We know what to do now in order to get it right. Get the sin out. Go and sin no more. We've been forgiven. We've been forgiven. And to see the truth, to see it, we can testify, Father, thank you for saving me. Thank you for forgiving me. Now go and sin no more. Father, keep me so that a worse thing won't happen to me. Don't let a worse thing happen to me. Don't let a worse thing come upon me. Not believing you is bad enough. I don't need something worse than that coming upon me. My blessings have been hindered. I've been handicapped. I've been in a place, Father, that your word calls it impotent. I've been impotent because of this. If I'm impotent, if I'm classified in the midst of an impotent, I'm classified as a deformed, I'm classified as a handicapped. All because of sin, of not believing you, and a worse thing than that come upon me, I can't handle the worst thing. Don't let a worse thing come upon me. Because I've got to believe you. I've got to trust you. Only let me trust you. Only help me to trust you. Only help me to trust you, Father. Only help me to trust you. Don't let me doubt you. I can only trust you. I can only trust you from here. In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. God keep you. Heaven smile upon you. My time is up. Amen. 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 Go in the strength of the Lord and know that we love you. Father, keep this people. Keep them in perfect peace. Keep them with their mind stayed on you. And help them to come to the building block to repair their lives. Their life will not be ransacked by the enemy. They will not be delayed or hindered, overthrown, overpowered, but you would give your children the advantage, the upper hand. Oh God, you would give them the upper hand. Give them the upper hand. Every one of these, oh God, that have accepted this time as a time of inspiration, as a time of motivation, as a time of insight. Father, help them to receive the upper hand. In Jesus' mighty name, transform their lives even right now. We give you praise for it. God bless you. God keep you. Heaven smile upon you. Have a good night, everyone, knowing that we love you. Amen. Be blessed.